Hey guys, Blockchain Bernie here with my latest episode with an update on DeFi on Solana. DeFi on Solana is, you know, Solana was invented to facilitate fast DeFi, to be the trading platform. And there has been happening so much after the FTX meltdown. You know, the main exchange Serum was kind of FTX funded. It all, you know, burned down into ashes. But what is happening today? I'm so happy to see so many great things on the Solana chain, and I'll dive into the details for you in this video, and there will be surprising things. So please make sure to watch this video all the way to the end. Smash that like button so that more people can see that content. Leave me a comment, subscribe to my channel. And by the way, we're building a scalable storage layer for the Solana chain, Zandium.com, and we give you points. So you can earn points for liking the video, for leaving comments, and all these type of things. So please do that. It's good for you as well because you can earn points. But now let's dive into Solana DeFi. All righty. So there are lots of things here. And let's start with DeFi Llama. DeFi Llama is the undisputed king of measuring DeFi activity on all different blockchains. I just clicked on Solana here, so it only shows me the Solana DeFi activities. We see the whole chart here from the initiation of the Solana blockchain sometime here, May 2021. We had that all-time high here in TVL. That's total value locked, right? We had over $10 billion here. And then we went right into crypto winter. We had the FTX debacle and everything. So everything went down. But look at this rise here, right? It's not that far away from the all-time high of the, it's about half now, of the all-time high of the total value locked. And if we look at that whole thing in Sol, and let's look at it just from the beginning of 2023, right? So man, look at this graph, right? This is in US dollars. It looks great if you look at it in Sol as well. But of course, much of this rise here is due to the rise in the Sol price as well, because as you all know, we've had a fantastic rally of the Sol price from around $10, $11 at the beginning of 2023 to 191 or so. As the time of recording, it's been, you know, over 200 a few times in the past few weeks. So that is all just awesome, and it's very well earned because there's happening so many things on the Solana chain. There are so many things that are only possible on Solana. But in this little video, I'm only talking about DeFi on Solana and what's going on with DeFi. So let's go back to DeFi Llama here, and let's just look at the leaderboard here, right? This is all according to TVL, total value locked. I mean, look at Marinade here. I mean, what a huge amount of total value locked here, almost $2 billion. We have the liquid staking with 1.2, and we have the native staking with over $700 million. If we look at just the liquid staking, Jito has already flipped Marinade, right? Marinade is kind of the old guys. Look at the growth rates here. You know, Marinade and Jito growth rates. So Jito is still growing way, way more. 1 month growth rate is like crazy, 67%. Think about what that means on an annual basis. So things are growing here. Another rising star here is Kamino. I had a lot of other videos. Kamino is like a trading platform, lending, borrowing platform. It's basically a one-stop shop for anything DeFi. So you want to do some DeFi stuff, you can do it on Kamino. They have an airdrop upcoming. It's announced for this month of April. We don't know what date yet, but, you know, they took their snapshot for the first season of their points on March 31st. I've earned my 5 million points, 5.1 or so, during season one, but season two is ongoing. I already have 5 million in season two as well. And I'm excited to learn when the airdrop will actually happen. And I will keep you posted here. So please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already done so, if you want to see what's coming out of the Camino airdrop for myself. All right, let's look back at the DeFi Llama now. So Camino is quite interesting. We have MarginFi, also a rising star here. But as you see, growth rates have a little bit stalled. There will be an airdrop there as well, but as far as I know, it hasn't been announced yet. And then we have Radium. It used to be, you know, pre-FTX implosion. This was one of the largest DeFi platforms. I personally still love Radium. But yeah, now they are like an also-ran. They're still number five. They're still growing here. Look at that, 259%. So I definitely do believe in Radium here. Blaze has been a rising star, $500 million in total value locked. And I remember the time when they started out just a few months ago, right? Mm-hmm. So everything is possible. On Solana, we see Jupiter here, right? So Jupiter, definitely also a rising star. And if we look at the prices of those tokens, right? Let's look into CoinGecko here. Let's look into the JTO token. That was the one that got airdropped to so many people. And look at it on a 3 month basis. Wow, look at that. It has crossed $5 today. Isn't that crazy? So that means a $600 million market cap. And I'll tell you guys, Jito is definitely still a very, very good platform on Solana. They do MEV, the maximum extractable value. There was a little hiccup a week or two ago, two or three weeks ago, and I made a video about that, where they had to shut down their mempool API because it was being abused and transactions were being sandwiched. But this little hiccup turned out to be not a big deal for Jito because all the bundles and all that functionality is still live, unfazed, and it's growing, right? So we're getting some real MEV rewards on the Solana chain. And I love to see that. I think Jito has a lot of growth ahead of it and well-deserved that recent rise here in their token price, right? And now let's have a look at Jupiter, right? They did their airdrop also. I received some tokens in their airdrop, and they are at $1.70. Who would have thought that, right? Because they launched in that range of between 50 and 70 cents and stuff. And it even went down, even though we were still in that crypto rally and Solana rally at that time. So they took a month or so, 6 weeks, until they really took off. And I also believe it's very well deserved. There is a lot to expect from Jupiter in the future, just because their main advantage is they own the customer, right? Everyone who wants to swap anything, they go to Jupiter, to the Jupiter aggregator, because the Jupiter aggregator is just the best GUI. It has the best, you know, all the other DEXs and all the other platforms connected. So everyone who's ever done DeFi on Solana knows Jupiter. They know when to come back to Jupiter to do their swaps. And I certainly do that. And that's a great, great asset. If you own the customer and the direct relationship to the customer, you'll find ways to monetize that no matter what, right? And they have great, great management. And yeah, and also something to watch here for the Jupiter token. So, but I want to tell you something about about DeFi on Solana today, and that is a real newcomer, and I think they are going to be huge. They are definitely going to be huge, and let's really dive into it. And that platform is named, let's dive into it here. They are already here at number 13, right? Sanctum. So Sanctum already has $105 million in total value locked. Let's expand this here. We have the Sanctum Infinity, Sanctum Reserve, and Sanctum Validators. So, and we see most of the total value locked is in the Sanctum Infinity. So if we look at Sanctum in general, we have a 308% growth rate month over month, right? So can you imagine that? So they are set up to 10x or more within a year, right? And what are they doing? I'll show you that here. So this is the app.sanctum.so. They have their Infinity token, and their Infinity token is a liquid staking pool that doesn't delegate to validators, right? So the normal stake pools, like the Marinades, the Jitos of this world, you deposit your SOL into them, and they take your SOL and they delegate it to validators to, generate that APY for you, those yields. With Infinity, they don't do that directly, right? They just buy single validator liquid staking tokens, right? And that means they can capture all the additional rewards that some of these validators offer, right? Some of them share their block rewards with you, which are normally not shared. They are not included in the 8% APY or so that you see with the best validators. The block rewards, they usually go directly to the validator, and through those single validator liquid staking tokens, some of these validators can share these block rewards with you. And they also give you rewards tokens, right? And with that Infinity, they can actually share that with you. So if you use the Infinity liquid staking pool, they invest into these things. And Infinity is something that has been growing a lot. And then you can also trade here, right? And you think like, well, that's just swapping stuff from A to B. I know that already. It's been so common in the Solana chain. But this is different because with all the liquid staking tokens, it bundles the liquidity. So even for small validators that bring out their single validator liquid staking token, the guys from Sanctum bundle all that liquidity so that you have that liquid staking tokens, even from small validators, are tradable, right, without any liquidity issues. So that is great, right? And here they have all their liquid staking tokens. You see them all here. And as I've mentioned already, we here at Zandium, we are working with the Sanctum guys. Here's the LSTs again. So all the LSTs on Sanctum, right? There are 20 right now. And we're partnering up with them, so likely Zandium will appear in that list soon. We can trade, and we have that Infinity token. Just as a little recap here. So, yeah. So that was my update on DeFi on Solana. Lots of things going on. Lots of growth going on. The rise in the SOL price is very well deserved because all of these things are only possible on Solana. And make sure you're invested in the right spaces, and be there when the rally continues. But don't bet the bank, and don't invest anything that you can't afford to lose, right? It's that simple piece of advice, even though nothing in this video should be construed as financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. And also, I don't know your personal situation or not even the country you're living in. So this is just for entertainment purposes, no financial advice. Please remember to destroy that like button if you like videos like these. Subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment because I want to discuss with you all these things. You have some additional information. You disagree with me. You agree with me, whatever. Leave me that comment down there. But for today, thanks so much for watching. Catch you guys later. Peace.